Just a reminder about the masks. We do ask that you please keep them on, especially as we have those who have not been able to get vaccinated yet within our service. We do want to let you know that Pastor Sarah is on vacation, but she is currently worshiping at Augustine First United Methodist down in St. Augustine, Florida. And we are so glad to have Pastor Dan in the pulpit. Following worship, we are looking for a volunteer to assist Kareem with counting the offering. So if you are able to volunteer, please let us know. Welcome all, and please remember to fill out your Connect card to keep in touch with us. Sinful pride, we have distorted your intention for humanity and for all creation. In your grace, forgive us and free us from the root of sin. As your church, though we have perpetrated the divisions of Christ came to destroy, guide us through this worship to serve joyfully for the sake of the salvation of the world through Jesus Christ our Savior, who with you and the Holy Spirit are one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Here at Grace, we know we are blessed in order to be a blessing to others. So let us do the small act of sharing peace with one another. Extend your hands to me and to others, and say to those around you these words: the peace of Christ be with you.
The peace of Christ be with you.
Prior to this portion of the letter to the Ephesians, the Apostle Paul has already reminded the church at Ephesus that because of their relationship to Christ, there is not be any hospitality or division between them. Since Christ is there, peace and their members together of the household of God. So he now prays for them to have strength and power to fulfill their calling as children of God. A reading from Ephesians chapter 3. I pray therefore that you may not lose heart over my sufferings for you. They are your glory. For this reason, I bow my knee before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and earth takes his name. I pray that, according to the riches of his glory, he may grant that you may be strengthened in your inner being with power through his Spirit, and that Christ may dwell in your heart through faith, as you are being rooted and grounded in love. I pray that you may have the power to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who and in Christ Jesus to all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we give you thanks for this day, for the time we spend together in worship. I pray today that either through me or in spite of me, that your people may hear your word this day and always. Amen. So today we continue our journey through the book of Ephesians. Thus far, we have heard about the history of Ephesus and the way Paul set the believers there for hope. Last week, we heard about the peace we find in Christ as the foundation and cornerstone of our faith. And today, we engage with Paul's prayer for the believers at Ephesus. It marks the first half of this book. The sermon theme today is focused on this idea of being rooted and grounded in love. I'm going to start with a bit of a story. You know, I was never the best gardener. However, I did conduct an experiment in seventh grade for the Connecticut State Science Fair that involved understanding how effective Miracle-Grow was in assisting growth rates of plants. We used a resilient and prolific plant. We used clippings from the very same spider plant for this experiment. One of the things about spider plants is that they are extremely invasive as a species of plant, and the root system for a spider plant will completely fill whatever vessel it inhabits, choking out any other plants that share its space. One of the controls in our experiment was that we grew these plants in only water or Miracle-Grow solutions without soil, a method called hydroponics. Now, watching and measuring these plants twice per week in our middle school greenhouse, I was able to observe the way roots grew and filled the space in the containers that we grew them in. You could tell the healthier plants from the ones that lacked nutrients. The roots were thicker and they filled the space quicker. They were far-reaching and strong. And though these plants were healthy and growing hydroponically, we were surprised by the overall lack of growth compared to the other plants in the greenhouse that were clipped from that same plant as our test subjects. The only difference that we could state between the plants that we were growing and the other plants in the greenhouse was that ours were suspended in water or Miracle-Grow solution and the others had soil. Our plants were healthy and strong, and they grew well in the hydroponically controlled containers. They were rooted, but they weren't grounded. They had deep roots, but were subject to the ebbs and movement of the water or the Miracle-Grow solution that they were floating in. With the ones that were in the greenhouse that were in soil, the strong and deep roots would also spread out, creating a stable foundation for continued growth and the proliferation of the plant. Likewise, we can have deep faith in God, rooted in Scripture, and we can be sustained by our own understanding of Scripture, however, without the connection with other believers, challenging our own understanding, we cannot grow to our fullest potential. Being both rooted in Scripture and grounded in a faith community, we grow in our faith and understanding of who God is and who Christ is. When I initially read this passage, I recall the very first thought that popped into my mind. It happened while I was reading that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith as you are being rooted and grounded in love. I pray that you have the power to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. The thought that popped into my mind was a memory. At the end of March 2019, I attended my first meeting as a member of the Board of Directors for the Reconciling Ministries Network in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. I recall that in one of our breakout conversations, I was part of a group with the late Bishop Danny Arachea of the Philippine Central Conference. We were discussing several things, most of which I cannot either recall or share due to the confidential nature of the work of the board. But one of the most profound things that I recall from that meeting was when Bishop Danny stated, "The gospel is three-dimensional, vertical, horizontal, and internal." The passage from Ephesians highlights what Bishop Danny revealed to us in the library of the local church in Pittsburgh. Paul offers a prayer for the people in Ephesus that they, as bearers of the Christian heritage, and us today, may be strengthened in faith, and that we may grow and come to understand the fullness of the love of God, who Christ is, and who God is. Let's break down Bishop Danny's revelation a little bit. The gospel of Jesus Christ is vertical. This connection between ourselves and God is crucial to our faith and spiritual growth. We nourish this connection through prayer. How do we maintain relationships in our daily lives? Prayer is communication. We nourish relationships through communication and time together. Prayer is the way in which we communicate and spend time with God. Often, we forget to allow God the opportunity to speak into us. We tend to say a lot more than we listen, speak a lot more than we hear. One of the ways we can nurture our relationship with God is to embrace a kind of intentional silence and contemplation. And yes, I understand myself, ADHD, that's not always an easy thing to do. Additionally, we build our relationships by getting to know others. Likewise with God, we learn about who God is and what God has done. We do this through poring over the scriptures. Our traditions, as Methodist states, the Holy Scripture containeth all things necessary to salvation. In spending time reading the scriptures, we learn about who God is and what God has done throughout the history of humanity. This intentional time builds our relationship with God and is rooting us in our faith. The gospel of Jesus Christ is horizontal. The founder of Methodism, John Wesley, wrote, "The gospel of Christ knows of no religion but social, no holiness but social holiness." As Christians, we gather and we build connections with one another. We share in times of worship, contemplation, prayer, study, mission, and care for others. Public actions of mercy in Christ's name, sharing Christ's love with others, is where we become grounded in that love. Without one another, we end up in our own echo chambers of understanding. But when we come together, we each bring our own experiences and understanding of who God is and who Christ is. We come and challenge one another. We exercise our faith muscles. Through the challenge, though it may hurt for a brief time, we gain strength of our conviction and strength of our faith. See, one of the things that I love so much about Methodism, or at least United Methodism, is the diversity of theology. We are not interested in indoctrinating one another. We are interested in theologizing together. There's even an entire section in the Book of Discipline that discusses the work of theology, how we live out and understand our faith. Wesley believed that the living core of the Christian faith was revealed in Scripture, illumined by tradition, vivified in personal experience, and confirmed by reason. It is in our sharing of tradition and personal experiences that our own preconceived notions of Scripture and the Christian faith are challenged, affirmed, and refined. We are rooted in our personal relationship with God and grounded in our collective examination of the Christian faith. The gospel of Jesus Christ is internal. We've already talked about being rooted and grounded. What more is there? That's the sermon title, isn't it? The rooted and grounded in love. What's important about this idea is that the gospel is internal, and that is when we commit the gospel to our own being. We are transformed in Christ. We are transformed and transfigured in the love of Christ. We are changed. How do we nurture this dimension, this aspect of the gospel? We nurture it by living out our faith daily in our daily lives. When we claim the Christian faith as our own, we internalize the gospel. When we allow ourselves to be transformed by the gospel, our outlook and what the world sees in us is changed. When we internalize the gospel, the world sees it in the way that we love others. When we live out our faith, others can see the love of Christ reflected in our actions and in our words. When we internalize the gospel, we become a beacon of the light of Christ in the world. The gospel of Jesus Christ is vertical, a connection and a relationship between us and God. Horizontal, our connection with one another that helps us to understand better who God is. And internal, transforming us and changing us to be beacons of Christ's love for all humanity. When we nurture the gospel in our lives, we are rooted and grounded in Christ's love for us and for the whole world. When we live into the three dimensions of the gospel, we have the potential to change the world with love. These three dimensions of the gospel are the breadth, the length, the height, and depth of the fullness of who God is and the love of Christ in the world. Paul's prayer for the church of Ephesus is also a prayer for us today. His suffering for the sake of the gospel are for us today as well. He concludes his section, this section of the letter, with this prayer and doxology. Now to him who, by the power at work within us, is about to accomplish abundantly far more than all we can ask or imagine. To him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus for all generations, forever and ever. Holy God, you grant us our heart's desire, not as we always are, but always you desire what is best for us. Anoint us with your grace, that we may be the love of Christ that urges us on as we walk by faith. Loving God, we ask you to bless those who govern, leaders of nations, countries, towns, and cities. Guide them into the world that you would have us be. And all those who lead in all manner, social, political, religious, fill their hearts with your wisdom. Guide us along the ways of justice and integrity toward all your children. Guide us to walk by faith. Great healer, attend to those who suffer in mind, body, and spirit, to the tired, to the dying, to the poor and the hungry. Help us to be your hands and feet, bringing forth a new creation. We pray for those who are lonely. We pray for those who are on our hearts this day, that we may either aloud or in silence. For this, for all we ask all this by the Holy Spirit who activates your love in us, in the name of Christ our Redeemer, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, we are so grateful to have you gather with us today, and for those who will be worshiping with us online when this posts. We would remind everybody that our adult Sunday school, Wesley Companions, meets on Sundays at 9:30 to 10:30, both in the Sunday school room and on Zoom. For more information, see or email Malcolm. Email address, I believe, is in the bulletin. We ask that you check out the Grace Garden, which is down below, outside the entrance down below. Feel free to take some basil leaves or pick some tomatoes if they're there. Next week, once again, Pastor Sarah will continue to be on vacation, and in her absence, we welcome Pastor Chadwick to the pulpit for continuing our Ephesians series. Following worship, we are looking for volunteer to assist with the offertory, so please help us so that we may have an accurate countdown. We will also have a time of fellowship over lemonade in Grace Cafe. Let us continue in worship and stand if you are able for hymn number 606. Come, let us use the grace to love. vertical, horizontal, and internal. Allow the Spirit to work in you. Allow God to work and share God's love with you. Allow Christ's light and life to show to the world through you. And as we go out into the world, may that light reflect who God is through you. Go from this place in love, in the name of God, our Creator, Jesus Christ, our Savior, and our Redeemer.